You need to stop the stream. Sorry.
All right, I'm gonna stop stream. Start it over again. If this doesn't work, we're doing something different.
Yay!
Well, we're not even streaming, are we?
No, not yet.
No, now it's doing something.
Is it?
That far behind?
Oh no, this is, you're just seeing the ad.
But the ad starts when it starts streaming.
My ad started too.
Yeah.
Wait, we might be streaming.
Well, how could we be that delayed?
I have no fucking idea. I don't know if they heard any of us talking about, we were talking about some important stuff here, guys.
Are you getting footage of screen?
Oh yeah, there's the screen. It looks like crap though, right? Guys, we're playing TIE Fighter. It looks like absolute garbage shit until we get in the TIE Fighter. So
enter your name, pilot.
Be prepared for it to look like balls.
So I'm just skipping over everything and going straight to flying then.
Yes.
And I didn't pick up the trailer.
Incoming ships.
Okay.
They're entering the area near Void B-18.
Oh, I can't see
TIE
the bottom.
Fighter Alpha
I can't
one.
See what
Inspect
my...
That's requesting permission to pass through this sector. Transport requesting permission to pass through this sector.
My presets are gone.
Oh no. We're picking it again. Or we're gonna watch Rich reset his bindings for 10 minutes. Oh, it's too loud, Rich, too.
Alright.
Fuck it!
Quit out of the game.
Oh my freaking ears.
Yep, sorry everybody. Game audio is too loud. What they're saying. Wait, you haven't quit out of it yet.
Oh my god.
Guys.
What the fuck?
What the fuck? Oh my god, we have two. Meeble.
Oh god.
Meeble, thank you for subscribing. And The Rising Sun. Thank you for subscribing. Twitch Plays Pokemon says, the Star Wars! It's happening in my ears! I'd say, game audio's gotta go lower than that even, Rich.
Lower than that even.
I would say so.
I know why the Force Awakens. It's because the audio is too loud.
Alright, now I have to...
Oh, you can turn the sound down here.
I have to quit out of the game to change anything.
That's true.
An open broadcaster.
Yay, Windows desktop.
You're right, I could change it in the game, though, couldn't I?
And then it wouldn't be so loud in your ears.
All right.
And then...
You just need to relax, Rich. You sound very tense.
I am very tense.
Everything's gonna be okay.
Nothing's ever all right.
Rich, isn't
Enter
it tense,
name,
like, when you're in charge of the screen? And, like, it's on you, the technical stuff is on you. Isn't that a terrible feeling?
I'm never tense, because I couldn't care less. I'm technically working right now.
Yeah, Jay, what are you working on? Would you like to give everyone
the
stream?
Oh, yeah, okay. Well, okay, I'm... the Best of the Worst Christmas Special is a gigantic undertaking to edit. I've been at it for 3 days straight. Monday, I edited for, like, 10 hours.
Uh-huh.
Yesterday, I edited for close to 10 hours, and then, like, 8 hours today. I just showed up in the studio because I have to pull some clips from some videos. But I'm going to give everybody audio sneak preview.
Are we sure, Rich? Why don't you reset your binding for real quick?
Oh, fuck.
Okay.
Did I do the audio preview?
Is everybody ready for the audio preview?
All right. I hope
ready.
You all can hear this. This is the audio preview of the Christmas episode. Yeah, take a guess on what that is.
I love it. And Rich, they're also saying game audio is still way too loud. We are officially working on that.
Sounds like dubstep.
Washing machine. good guess.
These are all good guesses, and they're all incredibly incorrect. I'm 100% certain that nobody will figure out what that was.
It is also not a dildo machine. But,
but dildo good. Machine?
Is a dildo machine a machine that makes dildos?
Hmm.
Or a machine that uses dildos?
What machine uses dildos? As like a way to power the engine of a machine, you have to use dildos
instead of pistons. It's dildos.
It's dildos.
It's using the friction. Oh my god! It's a dildo and what do you call them? What's the female or what's the?
Oh, the
fleshlight.
Fleshlight.
Yes, it's a dildo and a fleshlight.
Rich knew that one right away.
They harness the friction.
Fuck you, Bowman. That's what I get for helping.
Yep. Oh, hey, Dick the Neutral Boy.
Oh.
Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. But yeah, oh, you guys all know what a fleshlight is. I'm sorry.
The fleshlight made an appearance on the stream once.
Yeah, see, this is part of the problems we've been dealing with. So we see what you guys are seeing now. Is very strange. It's like a black box. We see TIE Fighter perfectly fine on our monitor, but you guys are seeing like a glitchy black box thing. And we're really sorry about that, but this is literally the only way we can get this to stream. Luckily, all of the TIE Fighter segments look good. And I'm looking back in the chat and I don't see any subscribers that I missed. So if I missed you, I'm sorry.
There might have been a couple when, because I can't see my screen when this is going on.
Right.
I think we missed two others.
I got those first two early on.
Oh, maybe we did get them then. I don't know.
I thought I got them, but who knows?
Next target. Where's next target?
Jack, try the 94 version. This is the version we got, people. It's the 98 version?
Oh, I can't calibrate the gamepad I'm using to work with that version.
Yes, we did try.
We tried that.
We tried the DOS version, the 94 DOS version, but we couldn't calibrate the joystick.
It was wobbling all over the place. The game was unplayable.
Yes. So you had to choose whether you could play the game but not see some of the non-TIE Fighter stuff, or see all the non-TIE Fighter stuff, or not play the game. So this is what you got, people. This is what you got, people.
And now I'm setting all of my for some reason it lost all of my bindings.
Uh-huh.
So now I'm rebinding shit.
Rebind it.
What are bindings? What does that mean?
Yeah, so I can tell on the joypad what keys do what.
Oh.
I'm putting the important ones on the joypad.
Game, this game.
Yes.
Has a million different button prompts.
Oh yeah.
Look at all the button prompts here.
Page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4.
Oh my god.
Page 5. Every single button, including shift button.
Why would anyone make a game?
Because it's like a flight simulator.
Okay.
Yeah.
You'll hate it. But I'm not playing it for you. So
you enjoy it, you play it. I don't care.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Fire weapon. Beam changer, shield, that's important. Next target, previous target, that's important.
That's important. While we're waiting for Rich to bind keys, we can talk about the very disappointing news. That somehow, some way, people made me root for Seth Rogen. I don't know if you know.
You have to be on his side in this situation.
And I fucking hate that, because I dislike Seth Rogen.
See, I don't mind Seth Rogen. I had no interest in that movie to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
When I first heard the concept, I thought it was a little, like, weird to be making a movie like that. The craziest thing to me is, like, what everybody's talking about now, there's so many different topics you could touch on in talking about this whole situation.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that all of it started with a kernel of an idea of Seth Rogen in a room somewhere, smoking pot and going, you know what we should make a movie about? And look what's happened.
Yep.
Not to say it's all his fault. Of course it's not. No. It's the fault of the hackers. But it's just weird to me that's... I wish there was all this controversy and all this discussion being brought up over a movie more worthwhile.
Yeah.
You know? I have a feeling the interview is not Dr. Strangelove.
Right.
So,
right.
It's a weird situation.
It's
a
very
really
weird situation.
Disappointing and sad.
Yeah, and I see people talking. This is not Sony's gaffe. Sony was going to continue with the movie. This is
theater chains.
This is theater chains. Yeah. pulling out.
And it's weird. Like, it's easy to say, like, oh, those pussies. And it's like, I can understand people that are upset from that perspective. But at the same time, I can understand, you know, they're a business and they're concerned about the safety of
we have game!
Customers. It's
absolutely.
It's just disappointing all around.
Oh, also, Kilroy McSpunk. Oh, Rich, that is so loud. Can you turn it down even more? It's so loud in your headphones.
Yeah,
how can you even hear
it loud? I don't know if it's loud to the
screen. Let me try. Oh, for fuck's sake, this is the most difficult thing I've ever
had. Oh, Sergeant Seema, Colin's here.
Oh, hey, Colin.
Hi, Colin.
Apparently, the Alamo Draft House is replacing like their screens that they were going to have of the interview with Team America.
Oh,
that's going to be.
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
That's my Seth Rogen impression.
Right? Ugh. Ugh.
I don't mind Seth Rogen. I first saw Seth Rogen in Freaks and Geeks because I watched that show when it originally aired and
sure.
I loved it. And of course, no one knew who he was then. And I was like, this guy's funny. Like, he had like a dry delivery to everything. I thought he was really funny on it.
Sure.
And I liked him in the 40-year-old version. But he's really funny in that. So.
Sure.
Does not want to be low volume. That's turned almost all the way down.
Sure. And I don't, you know.
You know.
Is it loud in the chat?
Yeah, can you? What do you guys think
Chat,
about
is the game audio too loud?
On open broadcaster, I have it turned pretty far down.
Yeah, but you can see where the green line goes. The green line still goes on.
How much lower than us should it be? The green line?
Lower.
Well, a lot lower? Or. I could probably turn it down even more. I mean,
would say turn it down even
more.
Oh,
fuck this.
Subscribers are saying it's still too loud.
All right. You know what? I might just do this muted.
What?
Fuck it.
Sky Dandy, thank you for subscribing to our cavalcade of jackassery and fuckuppery. That's what we have here, a cavalcade of fuckuppery. It's like, you know, thinking about Seth Rogen, like, he was great in the 40-year-old version, kind of like a sporting cast and, like, weird... goofy guy, right?
Yeah.
And then Superbad comes out.
There's a couple What the Fucks coming up.
The what?
There's a couple What the Fucks coming up.
Oh my god, there it is. There is Professor Physics. Thank you for subscribing. Who is the other one? Dr. Medicine?
Dr. Scientist.
I'm Dr. Scientist. And I'm Professor Physics. Thank you for subscribing, Professor. We really appreciate it.
I gotta rebind everything again?
It didn't save your
bindings? No, it did not save my fucking bindings.
This sounds like the worst game ever.
It's just hard to stream.
Yeah.
Lots of technical difficulty. You know what? Fuck it.
You do what you want. It's your game.
What are you doing, Rich? What's the call? You have to make the call here.
Volume is good now.
Now
at least there's that.
Now that it's off.
Now that it's off completely.
It's good. While Rich thinks on this,
yeah.
Superbad, which he wrote, or co-wrote,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Good movie.
Fine movie.
I like the Superbad. It's fine. It's good.
Solid comedy.
This is what I'm saying. This looks fun. TIE Fighter.
It's
look,
neat.
Look at you, you're flying around. Flying around in a TIE Fighter. That looks great.
Yeah, I can't select the targets, though, because my bindings are all fucked again.
I'm really sorry. Hey, Mike Shotgun. Thank you for subscribing. You sound like an 80s action hero. This is my partner, Nick Pistol. Where was I?
Anyway, oh, shit.
I'm sick of Seth Rogen, I guess.
I blew it up anyway. I flew into another ship.
Well, there you go.
Oh, God.
I think Seth Rogen suffers from overexposure and playing the same role in every movie.
Sure.
That's his biggest problem.
I can go ahead and agree with that.
I think he's an okay writer.
Okay.
And I've liked some of the movies that he starred in.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey!
I liked Pineapple Express.
Ghetto Sith Lord. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. Yeah, Pineapple Express was alright. Huh? It's...
That should be right.
It was the same gag, though. Every gag in that movie was the same gag, which is, this is something that normally would be very serious, and we're going to be idiots.
Well, that's the premise for the movie. There's other gags in it. I don't know, I like that movie just because they hired a weird art house director to make it, so there's lots of bizarre little touches throughout the whole thing.
Right.
Like, there's a great part where when they have, you know, in that type of movie, you have to have the buddies, they have to split up at one point, they're mad at each other, they get in an argument, they go their separate ways.
Yep.
And it's James Franco sitting on a playground, crying while eating a cheeseburger, and there's just this little chubby girl in a bathing suit, like, looking through the fence at him as he's crying and eating this cheeseburger. And it's like, that's totally David Gordon Green's idea. So there's lots of nice little touches in it like that.
Alright.
Of course, that's the only dumb comedy he made that actually was any good. He did a few of them, and they're all pretty terrible.
Sure.
But he makes good smaller films.
Okay. You know what? Okay. You know, and I just don't know if I even have strong feelings towards James Franco. It's just like,
he's fine in certain roles.
Yeah.
He's wrong as a leading man in, like, The Wizard of Oz, or what was it, Oz the Green Powerful. Like, he's completely miscast and stuff like that. But he's great in Spring Breakers. I think he's good in Pineapple Express.
I still have yet to see Spring Breakers. It's on my list of things to see.
It's a thing.
That's what I hear. Oh my god! Thank you for subscribing. I suppose your name is Oh My God.
Oh my god.
All right, the way the screen is cropped, I can't even see the information I need to see. This is terrible.
Okay, we're choosing a new game. Here's the weird thing about that. You can't see it, Rich, but the chat.
You know what? I can watch it in the preview and see what the settings are.
Isn't that weird?
Yeah.
I think we're choosing a new game.
If Rich wants to keep trying to play it, let him.
That's fine.
You do what you want.
I can sense the winds. This looks really neat.
Alright, fuck him.
Oh, I did. Silverwood 77. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. A lot of sub hype. And I'm down with that. Down with the sub hype for TIE Fight. Yeah, I stop talking now. Oy. Okay. And I unplugged my laptop. That's alright. You're right, Pirate Jake. Franco takes more shit than Jack Packard. I agree. I don't have strong feelings.
He was also great on Freaks and Geeks. It all comes back to Freaks and Geeks.
You know, I just wasn't that big of a fan.
Oh, I think it's a great show.
Okay. Okay. Oh, Billy Hecka, I can tell you, Rich is very, Rich liked Wing Commander, and is very excited for this new game from the Wing Commander guy. I don't know what it's called, I don't pay attention to that.
Star Citizen.
Star Citizen. You know, likes that. That's all I got. Oh yeah, did you see that one? The one with James Franco and where he was the climber, 127 hours?
Yeah, I saw that. He was good in that.
Okay. Mm. Alright. Franco.
I thought the movie was over-stylized for what it needed to be. And I understand that. They're trying to overcompensate for the fact that it's 90 minutes of a guy with his arm caught in a rock. I would have liked something a little more minimalist with it, personally. But yeah, it was a fine movie.
Do you think, was that the tagline?
What?
90 minutes of a guy with his arm out.
Maybe longer. I saw it in the theater, so I don't remember how long it was, but they were definitely trying to overcompensate for that.
Ah, okay.
It's a true story, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's The American?
A movie?
Right?
Is George Clooney in that? I think he might be.
I don't know.
I vaguely recognize the title.
Langus Khan says, while you're watching Rich play the oldest game in existence, what's your opinion on The American? I don't even know. I don't
know. Maybe it's a George Clooney movie, but I'm not even sure.
There you go.
Thantos, yes, Jerry is the movie I was thinking of. That's the exact opposite of 127 Hours, where it's Matt Damon and Casey Affleck stuck in the desert, and it's 90 minutes of them wandering around the desert. It doesn't get much more minimalist than that. A lot of people hate that movie, but I thought it was completely effective for what it was trying to do. Mm. I walked out of the theater and I felt parched. I felt like I needed a drink of water. So it's like, okay,
that's good.
Oh, Jack, I have to tell you about this film.
Jay.
I'm not going to say the title of it because I'm going to stream it on the New Year's stream. I don't want people to know about it ahead of time because they have to go in blind. I watched it last night. I'm 99.999% sure that nobody has ever heard of it.
Okay.
It's completely obscure. I had never even heard of it until last week. It's from the early 80s. And it's like if Don Doler, who did Night Beasts and Galaxy Invader.
Sure.
If Don Doler tried to make a David Lynch film, but not just a David Lynch film. He tried to make a David Lynch film, and that David Lynch film was David Lynch trying to make an early 80s slasher movie, that's what this is. And it gets so surreal and bizarre, and I'm not sure if that was made by someone that knew what they were doing and was intentionally making it surreal, or if it was made by someone just trying to make a slasher movie, but that director was completely insane and or incompetent. I'm not positive. But it's the most excited I've been by a movie in a really long time.
Oh my god.
It starts off kind of slow.
Sure.
But it gets really interesting and really fucking weird. And it was shot in rural Wisconsin somewhere. I need to do some more research on it.
That's awesome.
But here's the thing.
Okay.
And I'm not, this isn't like, wouldn't this be funny? Like, I legitimately want to remake it. I want to find out who's responsible for it, because I have no fucking clue. but I'm watching it, because it's shot kind of poorly. It's shot like a Don Doler movie.
Yeah,
it looks like a Don Doler movie. Uh-huh. But I'm watching it, and I'm picturing in my head, like, what it could look like. It looks like Don Doler, but if it looks like early 70s Dario Argento, it would be really something interesting.
Oh.
So it's the most excited I've been by a movie in a really long time, and it's a bad movie. But it's really interesting. So.
Well, I think this is great.
Mm-hmm.
You guys have heard it here first. This is the next movie that Jay's going to
make. This is an exclusive of something that will probably never happen. But it's yeah.
That's great.
I could see it in my mind as I'm watching it. I could see the whole thing of what it could be. And it's amazing.
That's so great. Hey, Morik! Sorry I didn't get to you earlier, but thank you for subscribing. We very much agree. We very much appreciate it. And, no, I don't think, Colin, that it's Patch Adams. I don't think...
It is Patch Adams, damn it!
Oh, I'm sorry.
Patch Adams is one of the scariest movies I've ever seen. So.
Yes. And the stream-a-thon is New Year's...
New Year's Day.
New Year's Day.
I decided to do it. New Year's Day.
Great.
Come cure your hangover with weird shit.
Oh my god, what a terrible idea.
for the stream this year, we're going to be using Ustream.
Ustream.
So, to the best of my knowledge, Ustream doesn't have the issue that Justin TV had, which was there's a limit of 1,000 people outside of the U.S. Like if it hits 1,000 limit of people in the chat, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Like, people can still watch it, but you can't enter the chat unless you're in the U.S. or something weird like that.
Okay.
I don't think Ustream has that.
Okay.
Sorry, I hope not.
A Horrible Glory says, I got my tablet set up in the bathroom so I can watch RLM Streamathon on the bathroom while puking on the bathroom.
All right. It sounds like you have this well thought out.
I think that's a great idea. Good luck.
I'm going to try and take it easy on New Year's Eve so I'm not in too bad a shape to do the stream.
What time does it start? Is it
noon? I've been doing it the last couple of years, noon to midnight.
So. Oh my god.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I don't know what I'm playing yet this year. I generally try to stick to, we play our stuff, of course, but with the features, other people's stuff, I try to stick to, public domain or things that are so obscure that it won't be any sort of issue.
And nobody's looking out for the rights.
No.
Alright.
I will be streaming the interview though.
Oh.
I have a copy.
Yeah. Oh no. But you know, I was talking to Rich about that, just to get back on the interview. That's the big news, right? And Rich had a great idea, which is, yes, that's exactly what Sony should do at this point. It's just offer it streaming, offer it.
Yep.
Offer
that's
it,
what I was saying, yeah. I was thinking that, too.
Reasonable price. Everyone and their mother will want to see this movie now.
Yeah.
And make sure, and then after you stream it, send the numbers right to North Korea. And be like, because you threatened, 10 million people saw this. Thank you for letting them see this movie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you... I have admittedly never been out to an RLM stream before. Mm. Do you talk during the stream?
No.
Can you talk?
I mean, I suppose I could set it up where we do, but yeah. I don't know. That's not what it's about for me. Like,
sure.
That's what this is at this point. It's right. Like us just chatting and
well,
stuff.
Well, that's why I'm curious.
Yeah, no. It's always just been streaming stuff.
Sure.
Trying to show weird things to people and, you know, I talk in the chat.
Oh, okay. I like it. I like it. Last year you played Death Lists?
Yes, I ended with Death Lists. Did I play Old Man after that?
Yes,
I think I played
you did.
Wolf. Okay.
Oh god, you guys saw Old Man? I'm so sorry.
It's a hate crime.
I have never seen Death List.
But you've seen Old Man, right?
But I've seen Old Man. And if Death List is anywhere near the caliber of Old Man...
Death List is much worse.
That's
on a technical
shocking.
Level, on a story level, everything about it is worse.
Shocking. Old Man was a disaster. Old Man was a joke of a movie. You know, as a filmmaker... When you're making a movie, that's usually one of, as a no-budget filmmaker,
Yeah. Usually
the first question you ask yourself is, what do I have?
Yes.
That I can film around. Mm-hmm. Kevin Smith had a convenience store.
Right.
Robert Rodriguez had a guitar case. That's how the story goes.
There's,
right?
What the fuck? The way this is, I really can't see who's
that's
talking.
That's all right.
So.
Thank you for letting me know. Ben Parsons. Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. So you ask yourself, what you have? What do I have? And the Old Man, they had a house.
Yeah.
But you know what? Everybody's got a fucking house.
They had a house and a Halloween mask that looks like an old man.
Yes, that's what they had. We just moved into a house. I found his mask. Kind of looks like an old man.
Why don't we make a movie?
An inarticulate mask. It's not. There's nothing to it. It's just a mask. Maybe I'll play Old Man again this year. That wasn't scheduled last year. That was just I played Death List and
people were shocked and amazed.
Yeah, I think it just came up in the chat, like someone, like the idea that this guy made another movie. So I was like, oh, I'll throw that on.
Oh, sure.
I think. I don't remember if it was planned or not.
Jesus H. Jesus H. Bacon Pants.
That's a good name, by the way.
The stream. Oh, it's Bacon Pants 09.
Okay.
So I don't know if he got the pants in 09 or if he's the ninth bacon pan. There's a lot of... The stream will start at noon Central Standard Time.
U.S. Central Time.
Colin says it would be cheaper to actually buy an old man. That might be true.
Probably.
Just find
an old man.
Go to a nursing home. I'm sure they'd be happy for the company.
Yeah.
Yeah.
From our experiences working with the elderly in videos, mm-hmm. They really like to talk. I think they're just happy to be out of the house.
Oh my god. Yeah, someone is asking whether or not there's any new comments from the Alien vs. Predator, which reminds me of something. Someone wrote a song for us.
Comments from what?
We did the comment video, Crocodile Brain.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And people are asking if there's any new great comments. I mean, nothing will surpass the Crocodile Brain. But someone was kind enough to write us a song.
Oh.
The Alien doesn't have eyesight, you dumb, fat, skinny fucks. The alien doesn't have eyesight, you dumb, fat, skinny fucks. Look, crocodile brain, like lion brain. Don't play the game. Uninstall it, you boring twat.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. You know, that seems like life. Talk about stuff you do like.
Thank
is
you.
Is this on YouTube?
No, someone just emailed me the MP3.
Oh, okay.
Thank you, Chris Newland. I love this.
And well, this has to be on YouTube.
I mean, I guess what I'm
sure you would have to ask him if he wants it on YouTube. But.
Yes. Maybe we can work on something with this song to get it up on YouTube, video-wise. We'll see. Once again, Chris Newland. I very much appreciate that song, and I think it's hilarious.
That's wonderful.
You boring twats! Yes, I will upload the song. Sometime. In some world. What? So you can download it and use it as a ringtone. Because I know that's important to all of you. Oh, good old Letty plays. Oh my lord.
I saw someone, I think it was on the message board, said that he's back.
He's back?
Like, he stopped making Letty plays and now he's making them again?
Oh my God.
I haven't seen, I don't even know his name or anything, so I haven't looked.
I just want to know what a Letty play is.
TGP Letty play, because he had a typo in his username. Grateful. You know, when you use numbers as letters, it's hard to read your username. Grateful H. Thrad. It Grateful Head? Is that supposed to be Grateful Head? Thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. That's not funny, Blake Sifkin. This game is not a lot like Rogue Squadron. He's being funny. He's being funny, bitch. Grateful Head. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Grateful Head. We very much appreciate the subscription. Sorry for bumbling your name. Jack had one beer. So that means I'm a little crunk.
I'm having a Roman Coke because I deserve it.
After seeing what you've been doing.
Yeah.
Knowing what you were doing.
This is an undertaking. This episode is an undertaking.
It's an undertaking.
But in the end, it won't be worth it because it'll fail.
Yep.
Well, what I will say, we're talking about the Christmas best of the worst. What I will say is normally when we do our discussions for best of the worst, we talk for like, I don't know, maybe an hour. Sometimes that's sort of the shortest, like an hour to like an hour and a half or so.
Yeah.
We talked for 2.5 hours for this Christmas episode.
Did we really?
And I'm trying to tame that down into something watchable. And I have some ideas that are a little different. And I think it's going to make it interesting, so.
Jesus H.
But it's, yeah. The last few days has been trying to tame the beast. Cut out all the fat. And keep all the funny. It's a challenge. It's an editing challenge is what it is.
That's, you know what? That's great. As long as it keeps you interested, that's the important part.
I was laughing while editing it, but that was also after like 8 hours of editing straight where you get snap happy and weird.
Yep. Yep.
That's what resulted in, if anyone remembers, our movie 43 review, where we didn't see the movie and just made up what happened in it. the editing of that one has all these like weird sound effects, and that's the result of me getting slap happy. It was originally just cut like a normal episode, but sure. I started to lose my mind, and so I added all this weird shit to it.
That's really funny. That was really fun. Oh, for anyone asking, I saw someone ask last Sunday. Rich did his very first solo stream.
It was terrible, but I warned you.
Because Jack's internet decided to go kaput. My modem apparently blew up.
Oh.
Or something. Mm. So I got a new one, and now my internet works fine. But so I couldn't do my normal stream or even Skype in to Rich's stream. So you got a taste of a solo stream. Mr. Formanelli, thank you for subscribing. We very much appreciate it. Dun dun dun. Right, see, they're saying you did a fine job. And some of them are saying, Jack, never leave us alone with Rich again. Says it doesn't matter.
I told you I was going to be quiet. Exactly. I'm quiet now because I'm playing this game. Unfortunately, I can't talk and game.
Yeah, no, we're here. That's why we're here.
My brain wants to focus on one thing or the other.
Do it. That's okay. That's okay.
No, I did not find and kill the red checkers guy. I would like to, though.
That's really upsetting.
I had a bonus stream after the stream.
Yeah.
I was just looking at the chat, and people were talking about thinking I was going to play checkers. Mm-hmm. Just without even having the mic on, I just started streaming checkers. Mm-hmm. And this guy I was playing against, it was a clear draw. Mm-hmm. He just refused to move. He wouldn't accept a draw. And it infuriated me.
And he didn't accept the draw because that would mean he lost, and that would lower
that would mean, his... No, that would mean he tied, and he just wanted to be a jerk.
Right.
He wanted to wait me out. And, you know, I didn't want to stay at the studio all night.
Right.
So eventually he got his way. Red won. Jerk.
So he did. He well, yeah.
Oh, yeah, he got his way. It worked.
That's terrible.
It is.
That is terrible.
And instead of having my back, some people in the chat were mad that I even offered a draw.
But you couldn't win.
No.
That's how checkers work sometimes.
Fucking TIE bomber. Ship sucks.
If only you guys could see this ship. It looks pretty cool right now. You can't see it. Because... That's how it works sometimes.
Looked okay in the preview.
No, it didn't. Look at this.
Alright.
Look at that. It's terrible. That's... terrible. They're saying it was Gobbledygooks. Or Mike. Maybe it was Mike. who was the red player.
Alpha 1, this is Mike Group Alpha North Marcus.
Nope, that's not what I want you to do. I don't know.
No, that's not
I hit a wrong key.
Oh sure, and for those of you guys asking. And this is something, we just uploaded all of the Space Quest videos to YouTube. A lot of comments have been made on my typing/reading ability. Which, I mean, one, I really appreciate your concern for me. but to answer your questions, yes, I am very dyslexic. Which is a true thing. When taking my test, you have to go take tests and whatnot. There's a scale of dyslexic, and mine was so fucking.
Oh my god, he's so dyslexic.
So fucking dyslexic. So it's a real thing.
So in other words, cut you some slack.
No, don't cut me any slack.
Well, it doesn't. No one will anyway. So
no. I'm not asking you to cut me some slack. I'm just telling you this is the truth.
This is a thing.
This is a thing. dyslexia is pretty complicated disorder. You know, some people have trouble inputting, some people have trouble outputting, some people have a little bit of both. My biggest problem is actually outputting. I have a harder time with stuff like typing and writing words in correct orders. And some with reading. Reading I've learned how to get over. Mostly by taking speed reading techniques.
I thought you were just going to say by taking speed.
Mostly by taking speed. I take speed and then I smoke pot to kind of cool off some of the speed.
Okay.
No, actually, I use speed reading techniques to read the sentence before I'm reading to double read it, if that makes any sense. It's been a while.
Okay.
So, in any case.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I appreciate all your concern, and that's sarcasm. And yes, that is exactly why I hate cutscenes, because it makes me read them. No, I've never been diagnosed with ADD or ADHD. None of that. I was not even tested for that. Mostly because my mom thought it was bullshit. But my mom is crazy. We'll get to that another time. So. Oh god, now you guys are all typing out of order. That's...
Oh!
You guys have no idea how that actually hurts me in my head. I knew, you know what? I knew that you guys would be supportive of this.
What jerks.
It's fine. Let them do what they want. I just literally won't be able to read it, so the comment will pass. And then, by the way, your comment will pass and it means nothing.
That's really the thing.
Yeah. That's
always the funny thing when you know that there's someone like getting worked up with their angry comments or whatever, like on YouTube, and it's all you gotta do. You just like go click, and it's out of your life forever. And
it's
they
beautiful.
Think they're accomplishing something. It's so funny. It means so much to them that they irritate you, and it means absolutely nothing.
Oh my god.
It's almost cute.
It is almost cute. Grateful Head, we asked Matt Hannon about the Yarn Lion head over the fireplace in Samurai Cop.
Yeah.
And he doesn't know where it is. He said that was just at the house.
Oh, he went to look for it.
Did he
post it? He's so weird with his YouTube videos. Like, he'll post one and then he'll delete it a little while later. I don't think he has any of them posted now.
Mm.
But he went down to the area they shot the movie, and he was just, like, walking around trying to find the house because he knew the general area,
uh-huh.
And he didn't end up finding it.
Oh.
So he did look for the house that they shot the scene at.
But like, that wasn't a prop brought to set. That was something that just this person had
just
in
the house, yeah.
And of course, if you have a Yarn Lion head, that is being featured in the movie.
Very, very prominently.
Jay already talked a little bit about unedited footage of bears.
Oh, we might not have been streaming at that point.
Oh, we might not have. Oh, that's right. That's what we were talking about.
Yeah, yeah. That's what we were talking about when we weren't sure if we were streaming or not.
Here's the question, Jay.
Yes.
Did you click on the close this ad link?
I knew that it was fake. Uh-huh. Like, I could tell because I've seen enough YouTube videos to know what the real ones look like.
Sure.
But I clicked on it just to see what it did.
Uh-huh.
Apparently, that website has lots of weird shit on it, too. I haven't looked through that yet.
Sure, sure.
But I mean, I knew what they were doing immediately. Like, I could tell that... The ad,
yes.
Or the skip ad thing was a part of the video, I can tell immediately.
Yeah, you know
what? That almost doesn't matter, because it goes on for another 10 minutes after that. And
yeah.
It's amazing, by the way.
Agreed.
It's another, like I said on Twitter, like the most interesting, exciting filmmaking happening right now is on Adult Swim, of all places. I don't know what they're doing, but they're...
You know what they're doing? Not giving a fuck.
I guess that's
doing.
It. I think that's where it comes from. It's just, we're going to do this.
Yeah.
There's no jokes in this. Although there are kind of jokes in it, where it keeps going on, and then they just occasionally have the little disclaimers come at the bottom of the screen about the the drug.
Like,
yep. I thought that was great.
Mm-hmm.
But even without that, just as a short film, I thought, if it didn't even have those jokes in it, I thought it would have been interesting.
Agreed.
I've seen some people say it's from like the same people that made Too Many Cooks, but it's not, as far as I can tell. Not directed by the same people, it's not written by the same people. I think it's just that it's Adult Swim is the only connection. Mm-hmm. But like I was saying before, we started streaming, like, I think it's more interesting and better than Too Many Cooks, but it's not going to catch on the way Too Many Cooks did. Because right. Too Many Cooks has that hook.
Yes.
The gimmick, the catchy song, the nostalgia for old 80s TV shows. Yep. New one doesn't have that, but it's a more effective short film.
It has a more accessible premise. Like, everyone mm-hmm. knows what a show intro is supposed to be.
Yeah, exactly, and it's deconstructing that, and people yes. understand that mm-hmm. more so than this weird short film about, like, side effects of drugs, like.
But I think Too Many Cooks also has a slower descent into madness.
It does, yeah, it does.
And it has a lot of jokes before the descent into madness.
It's more of a straight comedy video before it becomes something else.
Yes,
where it's still funny, but it's a different. It's not just like
it's an entirely different kind of funny.
Yeah, well, it's when it started, Too Many Cooks, when it started, I was like, okay, mm-hmm. I get the joke. Like, I understand this. It's going to keep going. Like, that's funny. And I thought that was all it was going to be. Mm-hmm. And then it goes off in a completely different direction, which is what makes it great.
Of course.
It's not just that one joke.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, but, you know, the slower descent also makes it more accessible.
Yeah, probably. It's not just a complete oddity from the beginning.
Yes, and I think with unedited footage of bears, which I love that's the title of it.
I wish it was held on the bear footage a lot longer.
Yes.
That's the only thing I think, if it held on that for like 2-3 minutes, I think it's less than a minute.
I've
only watched it the one time.
It's like 30 seconds.
Okay, yeah, that should have been much longer to lull you in. But aside from that, I thought it was great.
Yeah. Mm. No, really, really fun. Yeah, no jokes.
No jokes. Nobody well, the things popping up on the bottom of the screen, the disclaimers are the joke, but that's it. That's it.
But I think that's fascinating. Right. And for anyone who hasn't seen unedited footage of bears,
go watch it.
Go watch it. Just, you know, and without spoiling anything, the moment that she gets out of the van.
Yes.
Is when I was hooked. Uh-huh. Is when I said, this is brilliant. Everything after her getting out of the van is absolute brilliant.
Yes. Yeah.
Bears.
Spider.
What's happening over there?
The Rising Sun asks, so are Jack and Jay even remotely interested in TIE Fighter?
No.
I haven't looked at the screen once, so I don't know what's happening.
But you've never been interested in the game I've been playing.
Sometimes I am.
We talk about...
Here's the thing, like, as Jack and I are chatting right now, I'm also working.
Yes.
Right.
I'm gathering clips and footage that I need.
Right.
So, I'm not paying attention to TIE Fighter. Mm-hmm.
It's true. No, and I'm...
Wait, why do you need all that pornography on your screen for work?
What?
I've never seen a cock that large. I didn't think that would fit into a man's asshole.
You can edit this out, right, Jack?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. I'll edit this out right now.
Okay. Beep.
Hold on. I'm editing it out.
Okay.
Hold on. Wait. Wait. Okay, it's edited out.
Okay, good.
What's
no
it
one
out?
Will ever hear what just happened. It's great.
No, and this game looks really cool, by the way.
Yeah.
I would be absolutely lost.
Yeah, probably.
I wanna... And so I don't think I will ever play this game, but visually, it looks very neat. I like watching Rich play, because then I get to see all the cool stuff without having to do it myself. I like that. They're saying you're sassy tonight, Rich. Rich is sassy tonight.
He's in the mindset of a TIE Fighter fight.
That's right. Too many cocks. Ah, take the birthday boy, that's fine. Too many cocks. How long before you think there's a Too Many Cocks porn parody?
There probably is one already.
You think there is one?
Probably.
I don't want to Google it.
No.
Chat, does that exist? One of you Google it, because I don't want to.
Having to sift through the footage I'm sifting through right now.
Oh, yeah, I see that. That looks rough.
Yeah.
Dick the Birthday Boy wants me to explain an image link. The image is of Mike being credited as camera operator and video editor for something.
Oh, this has been floating around lately for some reason.
Well, I'm going to take a guess here, Jay.
Okay.
Mike was a camera operator and video editor for a video.
Yes.
And they properly gave him credit for it.
And they gave him a credit for it. That's the story.
I'm going out on a limb here, guys.
That's what it was.
Well, then there you go.
We were a fledgling video production company. We took a job. And that's it.
Oh, my God.
Isn't that an amazing story?
That, first of all, I never would have believed it. You know what? That was a great story. You're right.
I cannot find the footage I'm looking for.
Sometimes. Oh. Oh, he found it.
I don't think I need it anyway.
Oh.
Damn it. Never mind.
Does it not show you the thing you wanted to show you?
It does not.
Oh. That's it. Yeah, you know what? That is okay.
Damn it.
What'd you get?
I've shot an A-wing. Those things are a pain in the ass. That's a great thing.
Great. You did. You missed the story of that photo. Right.
Whoa. Got it.
You got
it. I got it.
They're saying you're doing great, Rich.
I know I am. You don't need to tell me.
Good. I don't understand what's happening. Rich is a TIE fighter pilot, and he's shooting down ships. What's to understand?
We gotta capture this outpost.
Mm-hmm.
That thing there.
Oh, okay.
But right now, one of the secondary objectives is to scan this thing's cargo.
Okay.
So
you have to get within range.
Yeah. It should automatically scan, but I gotta get in there.
Oh, wow, you gotta get fucking close. Don't shoot it! Scan it!
I already scanned it.
Oh, okay.
It's all good.
Okay, I'm sorry. I am going to play more Space Quest. Not tonight, but in general, I plan on doing more games like that. I think the next one we might want to do is... Rich has not yet played Leisure Suit Larry 2. And so that's a game neither of us have played, but is in the same game vein, so might be fun. Elvis Delvis, I'm not gonna sing the pee-pee song. Get out of here. Get out of here. Salmon, yeah, I've heard great things about the Sam and Max series. There's a bunch of games that...
Yeah, the Sam and Max point and click.
Yeah.
Almost all of the LucasArts ones...
Yeah.
LucasArts ones are point and click.
Point and click, yeah.
I prefer the typing out what you do.
Yep.
That makes you think more, in my opinion.
I agree. Like, I don't mind the point and click. I like a lot of old point and clicks. You know. You have to remember, I didn't have... a computer for a long time, so I didn't get to play any of these growing up. Just a console. The Rising Sun, I have not played the Arkham games yet, but apparently the Batman game got delayed and isn't coming out until like May or June, right, of next year?
Yeah.
And so I have plenty of time to play those fucking games. Plenty of time. I will be playing them. Maybe on stream. Maybe I'll play them in stream. That'll be a good excuse to play them. How can I sleep with the prostitute in Leisure Suit Larry without dying? I think you probably have to find a condom. I have no idea.
I don't know if you can.
No?
Yeah.
Or just, how about just don't sleep with the prostitute? Is that an option?
I don't remember the solutions to every puzzle in that game, Jay.
Right? I don't. I'm sure it might be an option, just to not sleep with her.
Jay, because you've probably never heard of it, the object of the adventure game, Leisure Suit Larry...
I know of the game, yeah.
...is to lose your virginity.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think my roommate in college had that game. That's why I know it.
Oh. Done.
You did
mission,
it.
Mission success. Time to dock. Mission's not over until you go back to your ship and dock.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah.
For what? Amichel87 just said, Jack and Rich, have you seen this Facebook account? Someone has made a Facebook account. First of all, I have not. I don't have a Facebook account. Someone has made a Facebook account titled The Same Picture of Rich Evans Every Day.
Oh, well, that's not an original idea.
Is it not?
There's a blog that's the same picture of Dave Coulier every day.
Oh.
I think it's still going.
Then, by the way, this sucks. You can't just take the same idea and put a new thing on it. That's not how things work.
Let me see if they're still doing it. Yep, they're still doing it. Dave Coulier one. It's the same picture of him every day.
Oh my God.
I don't know how long this has been going on.
Did they write it? I wonder if they wrote like a script to automatically do it. Or do they type something new with it?
It would make sense if it was a script. I would appreciate it more if they just manually did it every day. Oh, it's at the exact same time every day, so it's probably just a script.
Yeah.
Just a script. That's not as exciting. I mean, it's still funny, but it's not as good.
Yeah. That's really funny. The Rich Evans one, it looks like they type a little something with the picture of Rich Evans. Jay's looking it up.
I don't know someone.
Group Tau, engaging B wings. Nu, engaging A wings. Using your torch for attack.
I don't know how to find it. Engaging
A wings. Go to facebook.com.
That'll never not be funny.
I'm really glad, by the way, a bunch of people are just coming back now from having watched unedited footage of a bear.
Oh, good.
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 It's great. And they're saying they don't know how to feel now. It's true.
I don't know how to find this thing.
Damn it!
I don't know.
Oh, here we go. Wow, it has almost 300 likes.
There you go.
Oh, it's the archive DVD picture.
Mm-hmm. It's a good one. It's a funny one.
Well, I don't know who started this, where they superimposed the big face next to the... Because that wasn't in the actual video. Somebody made that.
Oh, really?
I know it's sort of a meme now. It's been around for a while.
Oh, okay.